Good evening. First tonight, Australia is taking a huge leap forward with its COVID vaccination program. The country's peak advisory body has approved the Pfizer jab for children aged between 5 and 11. They'll receive a slightly smaller dose than adults, and it will be rolled out nationally from January 10.
You'd never know it, but 10-year-old Ethan Davis has Crohn's disease.
It's an autoimmune disease, so it makes me a little, like, vulnerable to COVID than, like, other people without it.
In a month, he and millions of other children across Australia will be able to get the Pfizer vaccine.
Like, it protects me and, like, mostly other people. So, like, if I ever go back into hospital again, it protects the nurses more. It just, like, just helps, like, the people around me.
His parents have already vaccinated their oldest son.
There's a lot of countries around the world where they're certainly having problems getting vaccination to adults, so to have an opportunity for children, I think, is fantastic.
Australia's vaccine advisory body will allow children aged between 5 and 11 to get a smaller dose of the Pfizer vaccine from January 10.
It protects our children, it protects their families, and it protects their schools.
The Royal Children's Hospital surveyed more than 1,200 parents across Australia in July and found 30% were undecided about whether they would vaccinate their kids. 8 out of 10 were waiting on more data to trickle in from overseas, and 46% wanted to be paid for taking the time off work to vaccinate their children. The hospital expects its next survey to return different responses.
School has obviously opened up. Our young children remain unvaccinated at the moment, and that has meant we've had more cases in this age group. So those sorts of factors are all weighing into the really challenging decision for parents.
Children such as Ethan have a simple message for any parents who are still undecided.
You're a little bit cuckoo because, like, if you're not going to get your kid vaccinated, they could get COVID and then you could be in serious trouble.
Candace Wyatt for 10 News First.